Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Hi, I'm Israel Jabasingh, the director of Officers AS Academy. I'm also the economy teacher at Officers AS Academy. Many students will have this doubt whether RBI has to keep equivalent gold when they print currency. Say for example, if RBI wants to print 1 crore worth 100 rupee, 500 rupee, 2000 rupee, 1000 rupee notes. Now for that, this 1 crore equivalent gold, whether RBI has to keep it as a reserve or whether RBI can print as much currency as it wants. Now the doubt will be clarified if you understand how the monetary system started. Say for example, now you are going to a tea shop. You feel like drinking a tea. So you go, you give a paper, say 10 rupee note. The tea shop wala will give you that one chai. Now to get that 10 rupee, you in turn would have worked somewhere, maybe in government, maybe in some office, maybe in some IT company, maybe in some bank. Somewhere you have contributed to the production. For that, they have paid you a salary. Using that money, you are giving to the tea shop wala. Now the tea shop wala in turn has produced something like teas. He would have given teas to so many people. For that, he has got those currencies. With that, he'll buy tomato, potato, onion, bicycle, car for his family. Now, this way, for any transaction, you need a paper. So, for anything to exchange, tomato, potato, onion, bicycle, you need currencies. Whether these currencies have started since ancient India? No. Initially, when the society started, there was no currency. At that time, there was not even a king. So what the people used to do, you followed a system called barter system. What is this barter system? See, people just produced, say someone potato farmer. He has produced potato. He wants tomato also, onion also for his family. So what he used to do is, he used to give, hey, I'll give you one bag of potato, you give me two bags of tomato. I'll give you one bag of potato, you give me two bags of onion. Now, this was decided based on the production of each year. Say 1 year, tomato production was very less than potato production. Then what would have happened? I'll give you two bags of potato, you give me one bag of tomato. So this system was continuing initially. However, this barter system has its own problems. Say for example, today we are following barter system. Now what will happen? Say some student wants to come and join Officers AS Academy. The parent is coming. He is a tomato farmer. So he comes, he says, sir, I want to admit my son. So I have brought two bags of tomato. So I take those two bags of tomato as fees, admit his son. Then another person comes, sir, I want my daughter to become an IAS. So I am a potato farmer. So he brings, say, three bags of potato. I am accepting the three bags of potato as fees, and I am making, and that particular, his daughter is joining the academy. Now a third person comes, and he says, sir, I want my son to become an IAS, so I want him to join Officers AS Academy. Now, I am a producer, I am a farmer who grows cabbage, and he gives me two bags of cabbage. But I say, sorry boss, sorry sir, I don't want, because I don't like cabbage. Then what will happen to him? Then he'll think, okay, he'll go out, he'll go to the nearby market somewhere and try to exchange with some tomatoes, and he'll bring, say, two bags of tomato. Then I'll say, sir, what sir, already I have two bags tomato, sir, I don't want tomato also. Then he'll ask me, sir, what do you want then? Then I'll say, sir, I like cauliflower. Then to find cauliflower, he has to go to some nearby hill area where it is grown. See how much problem it creates. So gradually, this system of barter gradually stopped. Once the kings came into picture, they started introducing coins. Historically, the record says the first people, the kings who introduced coins in our country was the Mahajanapadas. Somewhere 6th century BC, they introduced silver coins. After that, if you read history, Kautilya in his Arthashastra, he would have written that gold coins, silver coins, all were in practice during the Mauryan regime. So he used to give the word rupaya for the silver coins. So that is how our currency still retains the word rupaya or rupee. Now, like this, kings continued with gold and silver coins. The first problem somewhere came when our Muhammad bin Tughlaq was the ruler. Now, what problem he faced? He had a shortage of gold and silver. So what he did, he started introducing brass and copper coins, replacing gold and silver. But one, nothing wrong in introducing brass and copper coins. One small mistake or a big blunder, you can say, he did is, he didn't take enough security measures in the coins. It was so simple coins. So people, once they found these coins, they thought, oh, easy to make. So every house started making using, because brass and copper were plentifully available. So all started making coins in their houses. So fake coins became in abundance. So economy started collapsing. In fact, the export import, when exporters, whoever, they didn't accept these coins. They thought, no, gold, give gold or silver, no, this brass, copper. So then Muhammad bin Tughlaq realized. So then again, he removed that copper and brass and replaced it with gold and silver. This concept continued even during British rule, that gold and silver coins, especially silver coins. However, when paper currency was introduced, somewhere in 1916, problems started for the British. See, they were engaged in World War I. Silver became a shortage in India. Then, so what British government did? Okay, instead of 1 rupee silver coin, I'll introduce 1 rupee paper currency. Now, people didn't accept, what paper currency? So they're rushing to the post office and trying to change their paper currency into silver coins and took home. So gradually there became a big shortage because people were not accepting the paper. So shortage of silver coins. So England became very panicky. Then what it did is, it approached its ally, war ally, US. So it asked, can you sell some silver? So US accepted it. In fact, around 50 lakh kg worth of silver was exported to India. So this way, that problem sorted out. So again, silver coins came into usage. Then people also started, oh, nothing to worry then. So gradually, they started accepting paper currencies also. Somewhere in 1935, the government of India established the Reserve Bank of India. So till 1935, the government only printed currencies. However, from 1935, Reserve Bank of India started printing currencies. Now comes that first question I asked, whether RBI has to keep equivalent gold when it prints currency. Now, last year's GDP. What is the GDP? Approximately, India's GDP was around 225 lakh crores. Means 225 lakh crore worth onion, tomato, bicycle, car, teas, everything was produced in India. Now, this much means 225 lakh crore worth goods and services have to be exchanged. For that, you need currency. Let us assume each paper 10 times it can move to different hands. So if 225 lakh crore worth goods and services means at least 22 lakh crore worth, 22 lakh crore currencies are required. Now, whether 22 lakh crore worth gold we have, definitely no. So RBI doesn't go by the process of keeping equivalent gold. So what RBI follows? They follow a system called minimum reserve system. So they have 200 crore worth golden foreign currency as minimum reserve, only that much. Even in the 200 crore, only 115 crore worth gold and gold coins are there. And balance 85 crore is foreign currency. So only that much. So how they then print currency? They go by the GDP projection. How much is the volume of goods and services produced? That much currency. To exchange that, you need currency, so they print accordingly. Say for example, next year, let us assume GDP growth rate is 10%. So what is 10% growth rate? Let us assume this year 1 lakh cycles are manufactured in India. Then next year 1 lakh 10,000 cycles will be manufactured. Let us assume 10 lakh tons of tomato are produced this year in India. Then the assumption for next year is 10 lakh or 11 lakh worth of tomatoes will be produced. So for that extra 1 lakh tomatoes, for that extra 10,000 cycles, you need currency to be, because those to be exchanged. So accordingly, according to the GDP projection, RBI plans the currency, printing, and places the indent. It has four printing presses. There are four printing presses in India which print currencies. One is in Nashik in Maharashtra. Another one, it is in Shalboni in West Bengal. Another one in Mysore in Karnataka. And the last one is in Madhya Pradesh, and that is called as Devas. Now, these four printing presses only print the currencies for our country. Then comes one more question for you. Okay, RBI is doing like this, no gold as reserve. How about US? How about China? How about England? Whether other countries also do, or countries like US have gold as reserve? See, in the year 1944, US came out with a system called fixed exchange rate system. So at that point of time, what they told is they will follow, whenever they print dollar equivalent gold, they'll keep it as a reserve, so that this dollar can be used as an international currency also. So anyone who wants that, no, I don't need dollar, then $35 was backed by 1 ounce of gold, means 28 grams of gold. So whenever US printed $35, equivalent of 28 grams gold was placed as a reserve with the Federal Bank of US. So this system continued. Somewhere in late 1960s, some people started going and exchanging, means giving $35, getting 28 grams gold. Even some countries like Switzerland also, which had a lot of dollar, US dollars came to Switzerland, because many US people were importing, say, Swiss watch, Swiss chocolate from Switzerland. So that much dollar would have gone to Switzerland. So Switzerland, one point of time, went and exchanged dollar with gold. So tons and tons of gold moved out of US. Somewhere in 1971, US became little panicky. They realized that if people come like this and exchange dollar with gold, then the entire gold reserves in US will vanish. So Nixon, the then president, gave a shock. He told boss, I am not into this game. I am moving out of this fixed exchange regime. So as of now, no country in the world, forget about India, no country in the world is printing currency keeping gold as reserve. Then what basis they print? Based on their GDP, trade, or keeping these things into account, and also inflation, all these things into account, and they print equivalent currency. I hope now, using the, because of listening to this video, you would have understood on what basis RBI prints currency. Thank you from Officers IAS Academy.